Before we will see the concept of what is meant by joint distribution functions as well as the discrete joint distribution function. Now let's see the another concept, that will be the marginal distribution functions. Okay, you already know distribution function. Distribution function means that can be represented with capital F, right? So here, whenever you have to be taking the marginal distribution function, main thing you have to be remember that be the, here we will be considered the multiple random variables. That means x will be present as well as the y will be present. Whenever the x and y both will be present, then we have to be set to be the, that be the multiple random variables, right? So here, in that case, we have to be set one variable to the infinite and we have to be check for the another. Okay, for example, if you take fx comma y, x comma y, okay, where you have to be take, suppose you have to be taking the y to the infinite, you have to be check for the x. Okay, in the next case, you have to be taking the x to the infinite, you have to be check for the y. That means we have to be set to the infinite. That thing you have to be mainly remembering this marginal distribution function. Okay, so here you can see the distribution function of one random variable can be obtained by setting the other variable to infinite. This thing is very, very important. Other variable to infinite. Okay, I already tell you. So for example, the distribution function means that can be represented with capital F. Capital F, x comma y, small x comma y. This be the distribution function. Next, so here we have to be taken the, not combinedly take the fx comma y, small x comma y, that will be equal to, you have to be taken the single variable, that will be the fx of x, and taken the another variable, that will be the fy of y individually. Whenever you have to be taken that be the individually, then that is said to be the marginal distribution functions. Okay, so here fx of x or fy of y obtained in this manner are called the marginal distribution functions. Okay, so for example, if you want to write, if you take the event capital A be the event, that will be the capital X less than or equal to small x. Okay, now if you want to take the another event, that be the B, that be the capital Y less than or equal to small y. Okay, if you want to write the intersection for this, so that will be the A intersection B, that will be equal to capital X less than or equal to small x, that will be the capital Y less than or equal to small y. So this B is said to be the P of A intersection B. So here this is said to be the sample space, yes. Okay, and if you want to take, now if you want to take the, now set y to infinite, you already know this marginal distribution can be represented with f x comma y small x comma y, where we have to be see the f x comma y. So here if you want to x comma, put the y be the infinite, means x comma infinite, right? So this be the, so if you want to take the y, right, y be the b. So if you take this be the b is equal to capital Y less than or equal to small y, so here if you want to take b be the capital Y less than or equal to infinite. Okay, infinite. So this be the, this will become the sample space, yes. Okay, so here if you want to take this be the probability of A intersection B, so P of A intersection B be the, how much you will get, that be the capital Y less than or equal to infinite, that be the sample space, yes. So here B be the sample space, yes. So this be the P of A. Okay, so here this be the P of A, means that be the capital X less than or equal to small x. You already know this be the fx of x. Okay, this will become the fx comma y, x comma infinite, that be equal to fx comma fx of x. Okay, in the joint distribution function I will be telling this the property, this be the sixth property, right? Whenever I will be tell that case, whenever I have to be solved the Mantle distribution functions, there I have to be solved this be the property, right? So this property will play a crucial role. Similarly, if you want to solve the fx comma y, that be the x comma y, that will be equal to now put R set x be the infinite, x be infinite. So what will happen? So this be the fx comma y, so infinite comma y. Okay, so what will happen? So this will become the probability of S intersection B. So this be the probability of B. So this will become the, so probability of B means, so that be the capital Y less than or equal to small y. So this will become the probability of, so this be the f y of y. So this be the f x comma y infinite comma y. How much you will get? You will get in f y of y. These two properties where whenever I have to be tell the joint distribution functions, I will be tell these two be the one of the properties. So how you can solve this? We can solve by means of this. Okay, in this marginal distribution functions, whatever you have to be remember the things, the first remember thing be the, whenever you have to be taking the two events, capital X less than or equal to small x and B be the capital Y less than or equal to small y. So whenever you have to be take the solve the margin distribution function, you have to be put one variable to the infinite. Okay, there you have to be applied the intersection. Okay, whenever you have to be applied the intersection, whenever you have to be taken the up to the infinite means, you will get a total sample space, that be the S. So here whatever the remaining things will be there, a will be present, P of a means that will be capital X less than or equal to small x, right? How you can write in terms of the distribution function, probability of capital X less than or equal to small x, that be the fx of x. Okay, and similarly if you want to vice versa, if you want to write for the y, you have y means you have to be put x be the infinite. There you have to be write some couple of steps, and as well as the sample set, the sample space, as well as the intersection, there you will get n fx comma y, that will be the fy of y. Okay, so this was the whole concept behind the marginal distribution functions. In the next class we will try to see the some simple question based on the marginal distribution functions. If any question they will be asked in based on the marginal distribution functions, how we can solve it, in the next class we will try to see. Okay, if you really like this video, please like my video, share my video, as well as subscribe to my YouTube channel. Thank you.